Good morning, students. Today we are going to see Standard 8th, Chapter Number 10, Armed Revolutionary Movement. Let's start with it. The agitation against the British imperialism were carried out in various ways in India. In this chapter, we shall get acquainted with it. We have studied the uprisings before 1857 against the British and the freedom movement of 1857. In the latter period, Ram Singh Kuka organized a rebellion against the government in Punjab. So all this content, as we had seen in the previous chapters. Vasudev Balwant Phadke. In Maharashtra, Vasudev Balwant Phadke gave an armed struggle against the British. He assumed that there should be armed struggle to fight against the British. He took the training of arms from Vastad Lahuji Sarve. He organized the Ramoshis and revolted against the British. This rebellion became unsuccessful. The British government sent him to Edinger. There he died in 1883. He built up an armed struggle for independence. So, according to the given content, in Maharashtra, Vasudev Balwant Phadke has started an armed struggle against the British government, and under it a struggle had been taken to a fight against the British government, which had led to Vasudev Balwant Phadke had taken the training of arms from Vastad Lahuji Sarve, as he had organized a Ramoshis and he revolted against the British government and tried to defeat the British government by the contribution of Ramoshis, and also this rebellion which was arose against the British government by the Ramoshis and by the leadership of Vasudev Balwant Phadke had failed. It means it had been become unsuccessful. The British government again they sent Vasudev Balwant Phadke to a jail, and Vasudev Balwant Phadke had died in 1883. He built up an armed struggle for independence, means he had tried to fight against the British government to get independence for our country. Let's see what are Chafikar brothers. In 1897, the plague commissioner Rand had resorted to terrorism and force while managing the epidemic of plague in Pune. As a revenge, the Chafikar brothers Damodar and Balkrishna shot him dead on 22nd June 1897. In 1897, a commissioner named Rand had resorted to terrain and force while managing the epidemic of plague when it was taken place in 1897 in India, as this was a disaster for our country. As to take a revenge, that Chafikar brothers Damodar and Balkrishna, they had shooted the commissioner Rand on 22nd June 1897. Damodar, Balkrishna and Vasudev, these three brothers and their associate Mahadev Ranade were hanged to death. As due to this incident, Damodar, Balkrishna and Vasudev, these three brothers had assaulted by the Mahadev Ranade, were hanged all of them towards the death. From the same house, three brothers accepted martyrdom for their service of the country. So as what? The three brothers from one family, from one house, had been hanged till death, and they become martyr for our country. During the same period, Munda tribe in Bihar, under the leadership of Birsa Munda, made great revolt against the government. As in Bihar, at the leadership of Birsa Munda, it had taken a great revolt against the British government in Bihar to oppose the struggle. The rule of British government in India, and to get freedom, they had started a revolution against the British government. Abhinav Bharat. In 1900, Swatantra Veer Vinayak Damodar Savarkar founded Mitra Mela, a secret organization of revolutionaries in Nashik. So as in Nashik, Vinayak Damodar Savarkar, he had started a Mitra Mela, and under his organization, they had different revolutionaries, they had joined to that organization named Mitra Mela. The same organization was renamed as Abhinav Bharat. So as after some time, The Mitra Mela had been named as Abhinav Bharat in 1904. Savarkar went to England for a higher education. From there, he began sending revolutionary literature, guns, etc. to the members of Abhinav Bharat in India. So as for taking education, Vinayak Damodar Savarkar, he went to England, and from them, for the Abhinav Bharat revolutionary organization, he has started sending different revolutionary literatures and also guns and different materials to fight against the British government to the members of Abhinav Bharat to India. He wrote an inspiring biography of Joseph Mazzini, the famous Italian revolutionary. The 1857 rebellion was the first war of independence, was stated in the book The Indian War of Independence 1857, written by him. So as a biography which was written for the inspiring biography of Joseph Mazzini, the famous Italian revolutionary, in that the rebellion of 1857, the war, the first war of independence, which had been stated in the book as the name they had given, the Indian War of Independence 1857, written by him. So as one of the content also we are having in our textbook about the Indian War of Independence 1857. Do you know, Swatantra Veer Savarkar was sentenced to 50 years of rigorous imprisonment at Andaman. He was there for 10 years in his autobiography, Maji Janmathe. He wrote down his experience of the terrible days in Andaman. Later, the government took him to Ratnagiri and did train there. There Savarkar started many social movements such as removal of caste differences, removal of untouchability, common dining, purification of language, etc. He was a great writer. He was the president of Marathi Sahitya Sammelan at Mumbai in 1938. So as the contribution of Vinayak Damodar Savarkar, a little information they had given about him. The government came to know about the activities of Abhinav Bharat. Therefore, the government arrested Baba Rao Savarkar. He was sentenced to life imprisonment. As a revenge to this punishment, a youth named Anant Lakshman Kanhere killed Jackson, the collector of Nashik. So as the government had been came into the activist of the Abhinav Bharat, as the British government, they know about the Abhinav Bharat, as they had started attacking on the peoples of the Abhinav Bharat, or the started arresting the people, whoever the participator of the Abhinav Bharat. So under his, they had arrested the Baba Rao Savarkar also, and they had, the British government had sentenced a life imprisonment to Baba Rao Savarkar, due to which the Anant Lakshman Kanhere, they killed Jackson, the collector of Nashik. At that time, a British person, his name is Jackson, which was killed by Lakshman Kanhere on the arrest of Baba Rao Savarkar. The government started arresting all those people who were connected with Abhinav Bharat organization. So as the people, the persons, whoever the members of the Abhinav Bharat, the British government, they had started arresting all that people. The murder of Jackson was linked with Swatantra Veer Savarkar by the government. He was arrested and put under trial. The court ordered him rigorous punishment for 50 years. So as they had, the British government, they had got linked that Swatantra Veer Savarkar is also a member of Abhinav Bharat, and he is one of the lead of murder of the Jackson, due to which he was put into a trial, and after that he had been given a punishment of 50 years of rigorous punishment. Revolutionary movement in Bengal. After the partition of Bengal, the outrage against the British became more severe. In place of local rebellions, compressive revolutionary movement started rising at national level. In various parts of the country, the youths, inspired by revolutionary thoughts, started establishing their secret organization to keep control over the British officer, to loosen the government machinery, to wipe out the fear in the minds of Indians regarding the British government. Overthrowing the British rule were some of its main objectives. So what was the objective of the revolutionary movement in Bengal? So as the after the partition of the Bengal, it had been taken a rebellion against the British government, and different actions had been taken that to inspire the revolutionary thoughts had been started, establishing their secret organizations also in Bengal, also to keep control over British officers, to loosen the government minds, and also to encourage the Indian people to fight against the British government. That all were the objectives of revolutionary movement which was taken in Bengal. In Bengal, a revolutionary organization called Anushilan Samiti was active. The Anushilan Samiti had more than 500 branches. Barindra Kumar Ghosh, brother of Aurobindo Ghosh, was the chief of this organization. This organization received counsel and guidance from Aurobindo Ghosh. The Anushilan Samiti had a bomb manufacturing center at Manikatal near Kolkata. In 1908, Khudiram Bose and Prafulla Chakki, members of Anushilan Samiti, planned to kill a judge named Kingsford. But the vehicle on which they threw the bomb was not the one carrying Kingsford. Two English women were killed in this attack. Prafulla Chakki shot himself with a bullet so that he will not fall in the hands of British. Khudiram Bose was caught by the police. During the investigation, the police got information about the working of Anushilan Samiti. They started arresting the members of this organization. Aurobindo Ghosh was also arrested, but the government was unsuccessful in linking him to manufacturing of bombs, and hence court set him free. Other members were sentenced to long term of imprisonment. So under this, in Bengal, a revolutionary organization named Anushilan Samiti was active, and in that 500 members or 500 different branches was there, and the Barindra Kumar Ghosh, the brother of Aurobindo Ghosh, was the chief of this organization. Under this, different by the guidance of Aurobindo Ghosh, Anushilan Samiti was working, and Anushilan Samiti had a bomb manufacturing center also at Manikatal near Kolkata. In 1908, Khudiram Bose and Prafulla Chakki, the members of Anushilan Samiti, they had planned to kill a judge named Kingsford, and under it they threw a bomb on which the Kingsford was carrying was in the car, but due to misunderstanding it had been killed two women which was in car, and due to which Prafulla Chakki thought that if I will fall into the hands of the British government, they will link to the Anushilan Samiti, due to which he killed himself. And Khudiram Bose, he was caught by the police, and due to investigation they got the link of having Aurobindo Ghosh in that organization, but due to not having any proofs, he was released from the police custody. Ras Bihari Bose and Sachindranath Sanyal spread the network of revolutionary organization outside Bengal. The centers of revolutionary work were set up at Punjab, Delhi and Uttar Pradesh. Ras Bihari Bose and his associate made a daring act of throwing bomb at the Viceroy Lord Harding, but he got saved from the attack. So as after that, another attack was done with the help of the Ras Bihari Bose and Sachindranath Sanyal. They spread the network of revolutionary organization outside the Bengal also, and different centers of revolutionary work were set up in the Punjab and also in Uttar Pradesh and Delhi. Ras Bihari Bose, he associated with by making a daring attack on bomb on the Viceroy Lord Harding, but from that attack also he was saved. Viceroy Lord Harding was saved from that attack. Their revolutionary work was carried out in Madras province as well. Vanchi Iyer, a revolutionary, killed a British officer named Ash. A letter, he shot himself with a bullet and sacrificed his own life. So as under this revolutionary movement, one incident was taken place in Madras province. As Vanchi Iyer, he was a revolutionary, he killed a British officer named Ash, and instead of falling into the hands of British government, he killed himself and sacrificed for our country. India House. The revolutionary work in India received assistance from Indian revolutionaries staying abroad. India House in London was an important center which provided for such kind of assistance. Pandit Shyamji Krishna Varman, an Indian patriot, had established India House. Through this organization, Indian youths were given scholarships for higher education in England. Swatantra Veer Savarkar received such scholarship. Madam Kama raised the issue of Indians' independence at the World Socialist Conference held at Stuttgart in Germany. In the same conference, she unfurled the flag of India. Another revolutionary associated with India House was a youth named Madan Lal Dhingra. He killed Curzon Vele, a British officer, due to which Dhingra was hanged to death. So under this India House, they had given here that the revolutionary work which was started in India had received assistance from different revolutionaries and as a contribution. And under this, an India House was formed in London, was an important center which provided different kinds of assistance. Pandit Shyamji Krishna Varman, an Indian patriot, had established the India House. Through this organization, different Indian youths had rose and they got the scholarship to take the education in England. As Swatantra Veer Savarkar, he had also received such type of scholarship to take education, higher education in England. Madam Kama, he arose the issues of India's independence at the World Socialist Conference, which was held in Germany. And also they had unfurled the flag of India. Another revolutionary associated with India House was named as Madan Lal Dhingra. He killed Curzon Vele, a British officer, due to which Dhingra was hanged to death. So, as for our independence, many people, they had sacrificed their life. Many people, they had become martyr for our country. Let's see the Gadar movement. During the period of First World War, the revolutionary work against the British government got a momentum. The revolutionaries felt that transfer of power can be brought into India with the help of enemies of the British, and in this attempt, help of India soldiers can also be taken. To take advantage of this opportunity, revolutionary organizations were set up. Gadar is one of such important organizations. So as Gadar movement, which was taken during the period of First World War, the revolutionary work against the British government was taking a place, become a momentum to our country, due to which the revolutionaries felt that transfer to power can be brought into India with the help of enemies. Means, if we will start facing the enemies, so we will have to have a contribution of our countries or the people. Contribution is needed, due to which it will be beneficial for us to take a freedom for our country. Due to which the Gadar movement had been started and a revolutionary organization was set up and which was given the name of as Gadar. Gadar is one such important organization which was working to defeat the enemies and to secure the life of our Indian people. The Indians living in America and Canada established the Gadar organization. So as the people who are living outside our countries, they had organized different organizations. Like the people in America, the Indian people who was living in America and Canada, they had established the Gadar organization. Lala Hardayal, Bhai Parmanand, Dr. Pandurang, Sadashiv, Kankoji, etc. These revolutionaries were the important leaders of the organization. So these were the members of Gadar movement, and the Gadar organization carried out under this people's guidance. These revolutionaries were the important leaders of the organization. The word Gadar means revolt. Gadar was the journal of this organization that acted as its mouthpiece. Through this journal, effects of British rule in India were pointed out. It gave information about the daring deeds of the revolutionaries. In this way, love for nation and armed rebellion was the message given through the journal Gadar to the Indians. So as from this movement, different revolutionaries, they were telling the stories of the Revolutionaries Act, which was taken in different places, and how the people, they had sacrificed to get the independence for our country. So as due to which a momentum will get, and a revolutionary or a encouragement people will get, and they will be ready to fight against the British government. The leaders of Gadar organization decided to take advantage of this war-like situation. They drew up out a plan of revolt in Punjab against the British. They persuaded the Indian soldiers in British army to join in the revolt. It was decided that Ras Bihari Bose and Vishnu Ganesh Pingre should lead the revolt. But due to trickery, the British traced out the plan. Pinger fell into the hands of the police. He was hanged to death, but Ras Bihari Bose escaped successfully. He went to Japan and continued his revolutionary work. So as under this, the leader of a Gadar organization, they had decided to take the advantage of this warlike situation, and they had drew up a plan of a revolt of Punjab against the British government, and they had pursued it to the Indian soldiers. Due to which, as they had got the British government, they had got the information about this plan, and they had pressed that plan, and Pingree fell into the hands of police. Due to which, the Ras Bihari Bose escaped successfully from that place, and again he went to Japan, and he started continuing the revolutionary movement by staying in Japan. The revolutionary movement was active in other countries during the period of war. The Berlin Virendranath Chattopadhyay, Bhupen Dutt and Hardayal prepared anti-British plans in cooperation with the German Foreign Ministry. In 1915, Mahendra Pratap Barkutla and Obaidullah Sindh established provincial government of Free India in Kabul. So as after this revolutionary movement, not only in England or not only in the American, but also not only in the Canada, but also in the other countries also, this had been taken a warlike situation. And due to this, in Berlin, the Virendranath Chattopadhyay and Bhupen Dutt and Hardayal, they had prepared anti-partition plans against the cooperation with the Germany Foreign Ministry. And under this, in 1915, Mahendra Pratap Barkutla and Obaidullah Sindh, they had established a provincial government of Free India in Kabul. So as they had decided to make the country free from the British rule, and up to when the country will not get freedom from the British government, the revolutionary movements will not be stopped in any situation. Kakuri conspiracy. The suppressive measures of government could not put an end to the revolutionary movement. After the suspension of civil disobedience movement by Mahatma Gandhi, many youngsters got diverted to revolutionary ways. Chandrashekhar Azad, Ram Prasad Bismil, Yogesh Chatterjee, Sachindranath Sanyal and such other revolutionaries came in together. So as after the cancellation of the civil disobedience movement, different youngsters, they had diverted towards the revolutionary ways. As names they had given, they become together and they become revolutionaries, and they become together to fight against the British government and to get the freedom for our Indian people. On 9th August 1925, they looted the government treasury that was carried in a train near Kakori railway station in Uttar Pradesh. This is known as Kakori conspiracy. So under this Kakori conspiracy, as on 9 August 1925, under the leadership of this revolutionary movement, on Kakori railway station, which is in Uttar Pradesh, the Indian people, they had attacked and they had looted all the material which was carrying of the British people, and that incident they had given the name as Kakori conspiracy. By taking immediate action, the government arrested the revolutionaries and put them into prison. So as the government got the information about this Kakori conspiracy, they had started arresting the revolutionaries and they had put all that revolutionaries into a prison. They were put under trial Ashfaq Ul Khan, Ram Prasad Bismil, Roshan Singh, Rajendra Lahiri were hanged, but Chandrashekhar Azad managed to escape. So as different revolutionaries was put to death, but in that case of Kakori conspiracy, Chandrashekhar Azad had been managed to escape from that place safely. Hindustan Socialist Republican Association. The young men influenced by socialist ideas decided to set up a nationwide revolutionary organization. Prominent among them were Chandrashekhar Azad, Bhagat Singh, Rajguru, Sukhdev, etc. All these revolutionaries were secular in their thoughts. In 1928, in the meeting held at Firoz Shah Kotla ground in Delhi, this young man established the organization called Hindustan Socialist Republican Association. The objective behind the establishment of this organization, another organization named Hindustan Socialist Republican Association, was formed. And what was the objective of this organization establishment was to free India from the British exploitation. It also wanted to overthrow the unjust social economic system which exploited the farmers and workers. So as also to stop the exploitation of the social economic system which were suffering by the farmers and workers in India, Bhagat Singh gave importance to creation of a society based on social justice and equality. So as Bhagat Singh had given the importance of for creating the different organizations which will be beneficial or which will be the side of the our Indian people and which will provide different opportunities to people and which will fight against to get the right for our Indian people and which will be seen for the justice and equality of our country. The work of gathering arms and execution of programs was entrusted to a separate wing of the organization. This wing was called Hindustan Socialist Republican Army and Chandrashekhar Azad was the chief of this wing. So, under this arm and execution of the programs was entrusted to separate wings of the organization and under this it had been given that Hindustan Socialist Republican Army will be looked after under the guidance of Chandrashekhar Azad. So, Chandrashekhar Azad was the chief of this wing. He was the main person of this Republican Army, Hindustan Socialist Republican Army. Members of this organization carried out many revolutionary activities. Bhagat Singh and Rajguru fired bullets and killed an officer named Saunders in order to avenge the death of Lala Lajpat Rai. So, as to take the revenge of Lala Lajpat Rai's death, of British officer named Saunder was killed by Bhagat Singh and Rajguru. They had fired bullets on him and they had taken the revenge of Lala Lajpat Rai. The government had introduced two bills of the Central Legislative Assembly curtailing civil rights to protest it. Bhagat Singh and Batukeshwar Dutt threw bombs in the Central Legislative Assembly. So as the government had introduced different two bills against the Central Legislative Assembly for curtailing the civil rights for the Indian people to protest against to this civil right, Bhagat Singh and Batukeshwar Dutt, they threw out the bombs on the Central Legislative Assembly of British government. The British government immediately raided the centers of Hindustan Socialist Republican Army. Through it, the police also obtained clues related to the king's killing of Saunders. The government started arresting the revolutionaries. They were tried under the charge of sedition. On 23rd March 1931, Bhagat Singh, Rajguru and Sukhdev were hanged in the Lahore jail. But till then, Chandrashekhar Azad did not fall into the hands of the police. Later, he died in an encounter with police at Alfred Park in Allahabad. So as under this, as the British government, they got the information about the Hindustan Socialist Republican Army and they had started arresting the peoples and also they had linked towards the killing of an office, British officer named Saunders, due to which they had started arresting the revolutionaries of Hindustan Socialist Republican Army. And under this, on 23rd March 1931, Bhagat Singh, Rajguru and Sukhdev was hanged in Lahore jail. And in this case also, Chandrashekhar Azad did not fall in the hands of the British government. But in an encounter with police at Alfred Park in Allahabad, Chandrashekhar Azad had been died. Attack on Chittagong Armory. Surya Sen was the chief of the revolutionary group at Chittagong in Bengal. He had gathered around him revolutionary like Anand Singh, Ganesh Ghosh, Kalpana Dutt, Priti Lata Wadedar. With this assistance, Surya Sen drew up a plan to attack the armory at Chittagong. As per the plan, on 18 April 1930, the revolutionaries seized the arms from the two armories in Chittagong. The telephone and telegraph lines were broken and they succeeded in paralyzing the communication system. After that, they gave a thrilling fight to the British army. So as by with the planning, a Chittagong armory under the guidance of Surya Sen, he became the chief of the revolutionary group of Chittagong of Bengal and he had the different peoples as they had given the names. All these peoples, they become the revolutionaries of Bengal Chittagong armory. And under his plan, on 18 April 1913, they had cut the telephone and telegraph lines and they had broken all that telephone and telegraph lines and they had made an attack on the British government. And due to the loss of communication, they had been successful in attacking the British government. On 16 February 1933, Surya Sen and some of his associates were captured by the police. Surya Sen and his 12 associates were given death punishment. Kalpana Datta was sentenced to a life imprisonment. Preeti Lata Vadedar killed herself without falling into the hands of the police. So as many different 12 associates of Surya Sen had been captured and they had put to the death punishment, and Kalpana Datta was sentenced to the life imprisonment, and Preeti Lata Vadedar, she killed herself instead of falling into the hands of police, as the picture of these two women they are given, Kalpana Datta and Preeti Lata Vadedar. Due to the uprising in Chitgong, the revolutionary movement gained pace. Shanti Ghosh and Suniti Chaudhary, these two schoolgirls, killed the district judge, whereas a young girl, Beena Dash, shot dead the governor during the convocation ceremony of Kolkata University. As this information is given to show the support of women also in Indian freedom movement, as Kalpana Datta, Preeti Lata Vadedar, Shanti Ghosh, Sunita Chaudhary, these were the two little girls, both of them, they had tried to kill the district judge, and a girl, Beena Das, she shot a governor during the convocation ceremony which was held in Kolkata University. Sardar Udham Singh killed Dyer, the officer responsible for Jallianwala Bagh massacre in London in 1940. So as Sardar Udham Singh, he killed Dyer, the General Dyer, who had given the orders of firing on Jallianwala Bagh massacre, which we had seen in previous chapters. In the freedom struggle of Indian revolutionary movement made an important contribution. These revolutionaries displayed daring and determination while fighting against the British rule. The love for the nation and attitude of sacrifice was just incomparable. The sacrifice proved to be an inspiration to the Indians. So as all these women's, men's, they, all the peoples, the revolutionaries, they become inspiration to us, and due to which the inspiration, the different revolutionaries had opened in different parts of our country, and they had started joining our revolutionary movement to get freedom for our country from the British rule. So in this way, we had completed the chapter Armed Revolutionary Movement. Under this, different measures we had seen. Complete the given exercise, read the chapter carefully and try to understand it. Learn given question and answers. That's all for today. Thank you.